Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. We have already seen in a previous tutorial that we can utilize the Django development server to actually run our Django project. In this tutorial, we go ahead and show you how to start the Django development server, provide you some additional information about the server to familiarize yourself with the basic features. If you're running macOS or Linux, then you can utilize the .slash command, manage.py of course, and then the command run server to run the development server. If you're in Windows, you can use py. Now don't forget the .slash is just optional. If you're on Mac or Linux, you can also type in Python 3 space manage.py run server. There are some other parameters that we can pass in to change the behavior of the server, and we will cover some of those in this tutorial. You may have already seen a later tutorial where we go through actually showing you how to run the server so it is accessible throughout your whole network. And that will allow you to actually view your Django server on any device that's connected to your local network. So let's just go for a demonstration to begin with. So here on the Mac, I type in .slash. Remember, you can type in py if you're on Windows. So .slash manage.py, there's no space there, and then run server. So that should start the Django development server. One of the benefits of this server, let's just, for example, close this. So we're told here Control C to quit. So I just close that and clear that. If I were to write some code here, now this will be an obvious mistake. So let's go ahead and try and run the server. And notice that it does inspect the code and return any errors before it starts the development server. So in this case, there is an error in our code base, so it won't start the development server, but it should give us some handy hints and identify where the error exists. So the Django development server is a lightweight web server written in Python. It is included in the Django framework, so there's no additional downloads to utilize this. It is important to remember that the Django development server is just for development. If we were to deploy our Django application onto the web, we would need to utilize a different package for our server. You may choose to keep the server on at all times, because as soon as we type any commands and press save, the server will reload, and potentially it will then capture any errors in our code. So if I remove this now, press save, you can see that the server restarts and everything is now fine. As you may have already established at this point, when we start a server, we're told here where the server is started. So this is the address of where we will find our server and we'll be able to run our application. So we can just type this into the browser and we should be presented with our Django application. It's important to remember, and you might not be familiar with ports. So here we have a local loopback address and port 8000. So the significance here is that this IP address 127.0.0.1 is considered or described as a loopback address. So your computer has an IP address on your local network, and you also have an IP address for the internet. IP addresses allow us to connect to devices, like a telephone number would. So here, this number here, 127.0.0.1, it's a reserved IP address that's assigned to your computer, so that if you want to send any signals to your computer, you can utilize this loopback address here. Because in order to access the resource, we need to tell our browser where to send the request. So in our browser, when we type in 127.0.0.1, we're essentially just sending a request to our own computer. Now, because the server is running on our computer, it will capture this request and then serve our Django application. The significance here of the port number, imagine the port number as a door. Typically, when we go online and access any web pages, we're using port 80. Now, that's just the default port, and that's why we don't use the colon 80 when we type in domain names, because it's just the default port. So any other ports that we want to use, any other doors, then we need to specify them. And that's why we're specifying here colon 8000. Now, these are all parameters that we can change, and I will show you in a later tutorial how to change the IP address. But let's just take a quick look here of how potentially we could change the port number. So if we wanted to change a port number to, for example, 8080, now you need to be careful here because there are some reserve ports for different services, port 80, for example, port 21, 22, and so on. So 8080 is a free port that we can use. So if I run this, you can now see that we're running on port 8080. So I need to type in 127.0.0.1:8080 to access now the server. For now, I would recommend for us to just stick with the default settings, and later on I'll provide some additional information on how to change the IP address, as well as defining who or what can access our server.